Gadget World for the best technical advice.
Hello guys, welcome to an all new interesting episode of Gadget World for the best technical advice. Gadget that we are going to take from our kitty is from the Korean flagship of Samsung, and that is Samsung Galaxy E7. It is one of the latest in the Samsung Galaxy series, and it is claimed to give a really good performance. The user reviews claim that the operating system and the processing features are pretty much satisfactory. So this Galaxy series smartphone, that is the Samsung Galaxy E7, was launched in India in February 2015. And when it comes to the display features of the Samsung Galaxy E7, well, it is available in a 5.5-inch display panel, and that too, it has got a Super AMOLED capacity touchscreen. And along with that, it has got a screen resolution of about 720 by 1280, which means that you wouldn't have much of an issue with the screen brightness and the viewing angle, especially when you're trying to read datas or when you're trying to see images in bright gray light, you wouldn't have much of an issue with the viewing angle. So that is yet another advantage when it comes to this Samsung Galaxy E7. Galaxy E7 runs on an Android 4.4.2 KitKat operating system, and the chipset being used is a Qualcomm Snapdragon 200 chipset along with a 2GB of RAM. So overall, the performance of this Samsung Galaxy E7 is rated to be pretty much satisfactory, and also in many places it is above the standard that a user could be expecting from the Galaxy series of this Korean flagship model Samsung. On to the storage facilities of the Samsung Galaxy E7, well, it has got an internal storage space of about 16 GB, which could be expanded up to 64 GB with the provision of a micro SD card slot. So almost all the internal storage features and the storage facilities of the Samsung Galaxy E7 is so much better, or maybe better or power, in compared to the rest of the smartphones that's available in the electronic market. So moving on to the imaging department of the Samsung Galaxy E7, well, it has got a rear camera of about 13 megapixels, which has got almost all the features like touch focus, autofocus, auto face detection, geotagging and panorama. And in addition to that, it could record videos of 1080p. Whereas the front facing camera is a huge 5 megapixel camera, which is pretty much satisfactory when it comes to the rest of the smartphones that's available in the industry. So when it comes to the imaging department of this Samsung Galaxy E7, it has tried its best to keep a lot of expectations for all those users who are looking for a good photography or selfie experience, especially when it comes to this wide video calling experience. This is going to be so much good for the users. The battery features of this Samsung Galaxy E7, where it has got a battery capacity of about 2950, that means it could have 18 hours of talk time and 88 hours of music playing on 3G. So the battery features of this Samsung Galaxy E7 has moved way ahead when compared to the predecessor Galaxy series models from Samsung. going on to the final verdict of this Samsung Galaxy E7. Well, I must say that with almost all these interesting features, that means it has been shown a lot of improvement when it comes to the Galaxy series processor models, especially in the imaging department and also the screen size, which you could see it's too huge, 5.5 inch display screen. And also as an overall, it is not too heavy. And this Samsung Galaxy E7 with all the plus, it is available in the market at the price range of ₹19,000.
The next gadget that we are going to introduce to you is from the Lumia series of Nokia, and that is Nokia Lumia 535. Well, here's yet another Lumia smartphone, and that is claimed to be pretty much in par with the predecessor models from Nokia. And not just that, it is claimed to have a wide angle, and with the provision of a 5 megapixel front facing camera, it is going to be definitely satisfactory when it comes to selfies and video calling experience. And it even provides the provision of a dual SIM. So let's get to know what are the other specifications that this particular smartphone has got to offer.
So guys, here I have the brand new and also the bright new Microsoft Nokia Lumia 535 at hand to be demonstrated. Well, here's yet another Microsoft smartphone from Lumia, and that too in the Lumia series of Nokia Lumia 535, which is launched in December 2014. And the main attraction about this smartphone is that it is a Windows smartphone, and also it comes in a dual SIM functionality. Of this Nokia Lumia 535, well, you can see that it comes in a huge 5 inch display size. So it's pretty much of a pocket friendly display size, and also it also comes in the category of huge display screen smartphones. Well, this Nokia Lumia 535 with its 5 inch display size has got an IPS LCD display panel. Well, it's pretty much evident from the screen resolution that you can find. It is comes in a screen resolution of about 540 by 960, which means that you might face issues with the viewing angle and also the screen brightness. That means irrespective with all those smartphones which uses a super AMOLED capacitor screen, the provision of an IPS display panel, you might face issues with the viewing angle and also the screen brightness. And in rest to that, it has got a Corning Gorilla Glass coating, which actually gives a wide range of protection to this Microsoft Lumia 535 display screen. Runs on a Microsoft Windows operating system, and the chipset being used is a Qualcomm Snapdragon 200 chipset that is paired with about 1 GB of RAM. And about the internal storage features that this bright Nokia Lumia 535 has got to offer for the users, well, it has got an internal storage space of about 8 GB, which could be expanded up to a huge 128 GB with the provision of a micro SD card slot. So that is like another wow feature which is pretty much evident in almost all the Microsoft models that is available in the market. Of this Nokia Lumia 535, well, you can see that it's got a rear camera over here, which is a 5 megapixel camera. That means, in addition to other smartphones that's been available in the market so far, it has got a dual LED flashlight, which has got autofocus and touch pocket provision, and the front facing camera. When it comes to the rear camera, it's just an ordinary camera with a provision of only a 5 megapixel, because that is pretty much low when compared to the rest of the smartphones, which is too much confident on their rear camera features. But when it comes to the front facing camera of this Nokia Lumia 535, which is provided over here, it is a huge 5 megapixel camera. So that means you could get a more than decent selfies, and also the video calling experience is made easier with the provision of this Microsoft Lumia 535. shows of the battery capacity that this Microsoft Nokia 535 Lumia has got to offer for the users. Well, it has got a battery capacity of about 1900, which is way not so far better, because it is pretty much average kind of a battery capacity, which provides about 13 hours of talk time and about 550 hours of music playing or standby time on 3G. So moving on to the final verdict of this Nokia Lumia 535. Well, it has got almost all the features that you're looking for in a smartphone that comes in an affordable price range. Like if you're having a tight budget and if you're looking for a smartphone that has got almost all the features that a smartphone that's almost all the smartphones in the market has got, well, here's Nokia Lumia 535, which offers almost all those features. But as I have already mentioned, that compared to the price range that it is offering, the imaging department and also this display features is not so appealing. And let me mention the price of this Nokia Lumia 535. It comes in a price range of about 7,700.
The next gadget that we are going to introduce to you is a camera from Nikon, and that is Nikon D750. Packed with an array of powerful features in an incredibly compact frame, that's Nikon D750 for the users, and it's definitely going to be a really good companion for your travel journeys.
Another DSLR camera from Nikon, and that is Nikon D750. All I can tell about this DSLR camera is ignite your creative desires with the help of this Nikon D750. The Nikon D750 has a feature set unlike the previous or the other DSLR cameras that's available in the market. That means it uses the same autofocus and metering technology that's been used by the Nikon's processor model, and that is Nikon D810. But apart from that, the Nikon D750 has inculcated a lot good aspects with its processor models, from its processor models. But apart from that, it has tried to incorporate a lot of interesting features when it comes to the imaging department, to bring it a step ahead compared to the rest of the DSLR cameras that's available in the market. It's fast and responsive and shoots about 6.5 fps at full resolution, and it's way far versatile. Yes, it has got versatile features that has been incorporated into the imaging qualities that this Nikon D750 has got to offer for the users. Like its versatile properties is definitely going to be pretty much impressive for all those users who are looking in for a good quality camera experience from the electronic market. This Nikon D750 is endlessly versatile. That means it shoots stills at different formats and also videos at a high definition and high resolution. So with all those important features, that means it has tried to incorporate all those autofocus and also the camera features with its processor models of Nikon's D810, and also it has tried to input a lot of interesting aspects. Like it has given a completely versatile feature for this Nikon D750. So I'm talking the Nikon D750 is pretty much an affordable kind of a DSLR camera that's available in the electronic market. This Nikon's D750 DSLR actually helps in capturing really high quality or high definition videos and photos at high resolution. And not just that, it could click images and capture videos at low noises, even at high ISO sensitivities. So all these are the important or the plus points that you can talk about this DSLR from Nikon. And that is Nikon's D750 DSLR. Stay connected. Sharing and transferring your favorite D70 photos is possible with the provision of all those features that this D70 has got to offer for the users. Like you could wirelessly connect this camera, that is the DSLR D750, to your smartphone or any other device that's available, and then you could access the memory card of this camera, and at the same time you can download these photos and upload this in your favorite site or share it with your friends and family. Enjoy enjoy the view. With the portion of its 3.2-inch LCD display, this Nikon's D750 DSLR actually helps in viewing all those DSLR photos that you have captured and also viewing all those videos that you have just taken to help you assess and share the images or videos that you have captured with your Nikon D750 to your friends and family. So moving on to the final verdict of this DSLR camera from Nikon, that is Nikon DSLR D750, where it has got almost all those interesting specifications that this Nikon has been introducing into its DSLR cameras, and especially Nikon has tried its best to keep up to its standards when it comes to the features and the specifications. Like, it has never put its fans down. Well, the same is kept with this Nikon D750, and it is available at a price range of ₹1,79,000.
So guys, with this, we come to the end of this episode. Hope that all the information we shared to you through this episode was pretty much informative to you guys. So until we meet again in the next episode, it's me, Devi Narayan, signing off. Bye and take care.